In this video, we are going to see how to create custom exception. That is, how the user can create their own exception, their program. So here, it is very easy and simple. So how to create? Let us consider, we want the user to enter the date in a particular format. If he does not enter it in a particular format, then it has to throw error. And it has to guide the user so that he will re-enter the data in a correct format, date in a correct format. That is what the idea of this program. So for that, we are going to write a custom exception. So first, before that, we will get the data input from the user in a HTML file. So in a text box, we are going to get that. For that, we are going to write a HTML file. So let us name that file as custom exception eg1.html. In that, what we have written is, yes, we have written the title. Then within the form, we are going to add the text box. So form action equal to. So when this user press the submit button, here we have the submit button. When the user press the, after he enter the data in the text box, that will be carried by the whatever he entered the text box. The variable allocated for that value is fdate. Okay, this will be sent to the PHP side. So when he presses the submit button, this file will be called along with this data. So this data will go to this file. So the method is get. Now, so what is the PHP side? This is what the PHP program, custom exception eg.php. Now, this is whatever the user is entering. It is not a existing exception. Here we are writing our own exception. So we have given, and we have given the name date exception so that it will be easy for us to follow. So this is not an existing exception. This we are writing our own exception and we have given this name. But what we have to do is we have to extend the exception class. Exception class is already there. So this is the child class which the user is creating, and we are inheriting the parent exception class. So that can be done through this keyword extend. So we have to inherit the exception class. So when we inherit, all the methods and properties which are defined in that exception will also be get inherited. So now we are writing within that class, we are writing our own function called error date message. So this is also a user function. Then within that, what we are doing is we are printing the value get message, which is returned by this date exception. Okay, so and we are printing any message. If the error is occurring, then we print this message, then we give the proper format for the user as a guideline. So with this, we close the class. Then we are using try block. In the try block, we are going to get that value which the PHP is receiving from the HTML. It is which we get it through this, and we assign it to the local variable. Then we pass it to the function which throw the exception. So get date function is also an user defined function where we get that value, and then using the PHP built-in function, that is date create from format. What it will do, it has mostly these are the two mandatory fields, where the first field will be the expected format and the second field will be the date for which we are going to check whether it is within this format. So what this will return, if it is true, if the date is according to this format, it will return true, or else it will return false. So now what we are doing is, if not, that means if it is not true, then we throw the, that is according to our expectation, according to the this format, if the user is not entering the data, then it will throw a new date exception. Throw new. Then here we are creating an object of this class, this child class. So, and we pass the message, error message, date not in proper format. This is the error message which you are passing it, a parameter. Now, this is what this, as we have, we are inheriting the property of exception. In the exception, we have this method so that we can use it here. So in that is why we are printing it here as this get message, that is date not in proper format, then the proper format will be printed. This also will be printed. We are printing it. L. And what we are doing is the thrown exception, we are catching it here. Okay. Once the error is thrown, we catch it here. So what is a date exception? Dollar E. So dollar E, here we call this error, this function. This function we call. So because this is already defined here. Okay, this is a function defined in date exception. So that we are calling here, which in turn will call this function, which is a method, one of the method of this exception, where this data, it will get that and it will be printed. That is what get message will do. So here this will be called, and all this happens when the data is the user entered a wrong format. Else it will print echo date in correct format and it will come out of this program. Now we'll see the output. If the user is entering it in the correct, this is the correct format. Okay. So if he entered date, month and year, if he entered this correct format and submit query, it says it is in correct format. Yes. See, like this, this is not allowed, because here itself we are saying that he has to enter with a hyphen. So in that case, it will show you the error, date not in proper format. So the proper format, what is the proper format that it will do? So using this, the user can re-enter the data. So now the explanations here is line by line it is explained. The date exception class is created as an extension of the old exception class. That's what here we are doing it. See here, date exception is created as a this is inheriting the exception class using the keyword extends. So is created as an extension of the old exception class. This way it inherits all methods and properties from the old exception class. The error date message function is created within that date exception. This function returns an error message if the date is not entered in the prescribed format. The dollar date variable is received through the dollar get function and passed as an argument to get date func, where a get date function is called from the try block. It just checks whether the date is in given format, and if not, it throw an exception. This error is caught in catch block and displays the error message. If everything is okay, the line next to date get function will be executed. So that's what we are doing. So here we have declared a custom exception or date exception, and then here we have return a function, where this function will call the message returned by the get date function, where this get date function is executed inside that try block. So the one which is throwing the error, that should be called from the try block. That's what here we are doing. So this date is passed, and here if it is correct format, it will not throw error, or else it will throw that error, and this error is caught by this catch block, which in turn will call this this through this echo statement. It called the error date MSG, which is declared here, where we print the message, get message, through get message. So when it is through get message, this message will be, whatever we pass this, that will be taken by this as an argument by this get message. And this argument is nothing but for this exception class. So that is printed along with the this message also printed. So this is how you write a custom exception. Now we'll see one more thing, where multiple catch. So far whatever we have seen is single catch. For one try there is a catch, but for one try there will be more catches also, because one exception may create more errors. So each error you can write different catch blocks. So here if you see that, let us see this example. The same example, date exception, extends exception, error date, all these things are same, but here we have written one more exception handling. It is name exception, extends exception. What we are doing is, here we are getting two inputs. See, in the HTML file, here we are getting two values. One is date and name. So you have to modify your HTML accordingly. So one more data we have to read, text box, and we have to get the data. So here we have two exception we have written here. So under the first exception is date exception, and another exception we have written is name exception. This is also user defined. This is also event. Both extends exception. So in this, it has its own error name message. So this also have whatever message we are passing for this, that will be caught by this. And along with that, this information is also concatenated. Name should not be empty. So now with this we are closing. So there are two child classes, both inherit exception. Okay. Now in try block, we are getting the value from the HTML file name and put it in the local variables. Now, as usual, this getDate function, we pass it, and it say if it gives any error, it say date in. This will be called. So when it calls, as usual, whatever we have seen in the previous example, it checks for the given format. If it is not satisfied, then it throw new exception. Okay, and when it throw new exception, what happens? This catch will be caught, and that will be passed. That argument will be passed, and we call this error date MSG, which is defined within the date exception. And this message which we are sending it to this room, that also will be displayed along with this proper format. Now, if the date is okay, then if the name field is not entered, if it is left empty, then what happened? Again, an exception. That's where we are writing an exception. So it checks here. See here. Catch. Name exception already. Then we are printing it the screen. That is, we are calling this error name message. So what it is doing? This get name. Here. Get name function. If it is okay, then this will be executed. If there is no error, then this statement will be executed. If then this get name function will be called, which throw the error. So what getName function will do, it get the name, and then if it is empty, then it throw an exception. And that name exception must enter some value. This is the value which is it's passing, which is caught by the getMessage of here. See here, getMessage. So that will be printed along with this value. So now we'll see how it get executes. In the HTML file, you have to get two fields, one is for date and name, and if it is kept empty, now this is okay. So that value is printed in correct format. But for this, it will throw the error. Must enter some value. Name should not be value. So the must enter some value means this is what the one which is returned by this, and it is get by this get message, and it will print, and it is concatenated with this information also. So that's what explained here. So in general, what are all the functions which can be used from exception class? Get message of the exception, then get code of the, what is the error code, that can be get by this get code, then get file, what is the source file name, get line, in which line the particular error occurs, that can be get by get line, get trace, and then get trace as a string. All those things can be done. So what are the rules for exception? Code may be surrounded in a try block to help catch potential exceptions. Each try block or throw must have at least one corresponding catch block. Multiple class blocks can be used to catch different classes of exception. That's now we have seen now. Exception can be thrown in a catch block within a try block.